Hello and welcome back to Mini Melodies at Home. My name's Tom and I'm really glad that you've joined us again to sing lots of songs all about our favourite fruits today. And we're going to start off with the Hello song. Hello all the boys, hello all the boys, hello all the boys, it's good to see you here. Hello all the girls, hello all the girls, hello all the girls, it's good to see you here. Hello grown-ups, hello grown-ups, hello grown-ups, it's good to see you here. And give yourself a bit of a clap. And now our first song comes to us from Hazel. We're going to find out all about the things she's going to be making with her fruits today.
Hello. I got my Tesco delivery yesterday and they delivered some fruit, some bananas, some rhubarb and some apples. And I've been wondering what I can make with them today that would be really fun to eat. What shall we make with our fruit today? Fruit today, fruit today. What shall we make with our fruit today? What shall we make today? We could make a banana cake, banana cake, banana cake. We could make a banana cake. That's what we make today. Or we could make a rhubarb fool, rhubarb fool, rhubarb fool. We could make a rhubarb fool, that's what we'll make today. Or we could make an apple crumble, apple crumble, apple crumble. We could make an apple crumble, that's what we'll make today. Or we could just sit and eat it all up, eat it all up, eat it all up. We could just sit and eat it all up, that's what we'll do today.
Oh, thank you, Hazel. And Hazel's going to be back a little bit later for another song as well. Now, I'm hoping you might have a plate with you, a non-breakable plate, some spoons, which you can use as tapping sticks, and some floaty material which you can use to dance with. And maybe you'll be using some of those at home for our next song, which is one that I know is one of our favourites, so we've got it again this week as we did last week, which is oranges and lemons. Now I've got my greengrocer's basket here, I've got my tray, and I can find, yeah, I've got some oranges, you see, an orange with a smiley face, and I've got a lemon, I've got a few lemons, can you see? So I think for our next song, we should sing Oranges and Lemons. Here we go. This one on my finger. And I'll hold this one. Here we go. Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement. You owe me 5 farthings, say the bells of St. Martin. When will you pay me? Say the bells of Old Bailey. When I get rich, say the bells of Shoreditch. When will that be? Say the bells of Stepney. I'm sure I don't know, says the great bell of Bow. Let's do that again, shall we? Look out for the orange waving at you. Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement. You owe me 5 farthings, say the bells of St. Martin. When will you pay me, say the bells of Old Bailey. When I grow rich, say the bells of Shoreditch. When will that be, say the bells of Stepney. I'm sure I don't know, says the great bell of Bow. Let's say bye-bye to our orange and our lemon. Well done. Now for another song. We did this one last week, but this time we got the music to go with it as well, which is I Like to Eat Bananas. So let's imagine eating a banana. I like to eat bananas. I've got one here. To taste and see that the Lord is good. I like to eat bananas. here taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. Let's go for some grapes now. I like to eat some grapes, to taste and see that the Lord is good. I like to eat some grapes, to taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. Now let's go on to some strawberries. I like to eat strawberries, to taste and see that the Lord is good. I like to eat strawberries, to taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good, the Lord is good. I'll taste and see that the Lord is good. Give yourselves a bit of a clap and maybe see if you can find your spoons, which today we're going to be using as tapping sticks. So, we've got a rhyme all about apples, pears and strawberries. See if you can tap along. Apples, pears and strawberries, all these fruits are good for me, for my snacks and with my lunch. Grapes are also great to munch. Apples, pears and strawberries, all these fruits are good for me. Let's do it again then. Apples, pears and strawberries, all these fruits are good for me, for my snacks and with my lunch. Grapes are also great to munch. Apples, pears and strawberries, all these fruits are good for me. Well done. The next rhyme that we've got is all about some pickled peppers. And this is called a tongue twister because we have lots of words that all sound a bit like each other and it muddles up our mouths. So we'll see if I get muddled and see if you get muddled at home as well. But let's give it a go and it will be lots of fun even if we do get a little bit muddled. So I'll start off doing it quite slowly so you can try and join in with this one. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, how many pickled peppers did Peter Piper pick? Shall we do that a bit faster? Here we go. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, how many pickled peppers did Peter Piper pick? Well done if you caught up at home with that one as well. Now, shall I see if I can do it really, 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 really quickly using a bit of help of technology as well? Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picks a peck of pickled peppers, how many pickled peppers did Peter Piper pick? Wow, that was good, wasn't it? That was very, very, very fast. Now I'm going to go back to normal speed. I've got my greengrocer's tray here again, and I'm going to imagine that I'm a real greengrocer and I need a greengrocer's hat. And I've got the hat that I stuck together last week, my special greengrocer's hat. Can you see how trendy and fashionable this one is? So I am going to pop this one onto my head. And hopefully you can see it now, if I just move back so you can get the best view of my wonderful greengrocer's hat. It's a very valuable hat, a very important one. I wouldn't want to lose my hat. So, if my hat for any reason falls off my head, or if it blows off, or if I sneeze and it comes off, or if anything happens that means it comes away from my head, please can you let me know? The best way to do that is to get your drums or your plates and to get a spoon and to tap the plate like this so that I can hear you and I will know. So remember, you're watching my hat. If it falls off, you just need to let me know. I can hear some drumming already. Why can I hear some drumming? My hat's on my... It's fallen off my head, hasn't it? Oh, no. Has it gone over here? Has it gone over here? Is it down here? It is. It's beneath me. It's down at my feet here. Thank you for letting me know. I've picked that one up. I can put my hat back on my head. Oh, sorry, I've got a bit of a sneeze coming. Chew! Oh, dear. That was a bit of a sneeze, wasn't it? Oh, no, my hat came off, didn't it? Thank you for letting me know at home again. Has it fallen beneath me again? Not quite. Is it over this way? Is it over... It's over this way. I see. It's on the floor just over here. Okay. There we go. Let's just pop that back onto my head. I'll push it down nice and tightly to keep it nice and strong on my head. Now, I can feel a bit of a breeze. I shouldn't have left the window open before I started Mini Melodies today. Oh, I can really feel the wind blowing over now. Oh, it's going right whooshing over my hair. Oh, no. Has it blown my hats off? Oh, dear. Let me get it from... Has it gone over this way? Over this way and then it blew off? Oh, dear. Let me find my hat. Here we go. Maybe one last time. I'll put it on to make it really tight. I'm going to screw it onto my head. So it's really, really, really tight. Here we go. Okay. I don't think anything can happen to my hat now. In fact, I'm just going to have a bit of a rest now because I'm really tired with all my hat blowing off. It's made me quite sleepy. So I'm going to rub my eyes. Have a big yawn. Oh, dear. I'm really tired. I'm going to just have a sleep now. Oh, I can't sleep now. There's lots of banging going on. Oh, is it my hat's falling off again? Thank you for letting me know. Is it in front of me? Is it down here in front of me? No. Is it on my side? The other side. Is it on my other side? Where's it gone? It's behind me. Okay, thank you. I can see it down here. And you know what I'm going to do to keep my hat really safe? Rather than putting it straight on my head, I'm going to put it over here where I know it will be really, really safe. Here we go. I just nearly get tied up with my chair as well and my microphone wire. I'll try not to do that again. Ah, well, thank you very much for helping me to look after my hat. I think I do need a bit of a break now, so I'm going to pass over to Hazel again, who's going to sing us a song, and we can join in with her about some of the apples that she's got from the fruit tree.
We've got some apples picked from a tree. Apples rosy red for you and shiny green for me. Some of them are big, some of them are small, some of them are oval, some are like a ball. Some of them are sour, ooh, some of them are sweet, yum. Lots of lovely apples for you and me to eat.
Thank you, Hazel. Well, I'm joined now by our monkey again. Can you all say hello to our monkey? Say hello. And monkeys love to eat bananas, don't they? There we go. Monkeys also have to wash their clothes. So we're going to sing the song now all about the monkey washing her clothes. Don't forget to look out for the bubbles. Down in the jungle where nobody goes, there's a great big monkey washing her clothes with a rub-a-dub here and a rub-a-dub there. That's the way she washes her clothes. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. That's the way she washes her clothes. Shall we do that? Wow, look at all these bubbles. Shall we do that again? Down in the jungle where nobody goes, there's a great big monkey washing her clothes with a rub-a-dub here and a rub-a-dub there. That's the way she washes her clothes. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. Boom buddy, boom buddy, boogie woogie, yeah. That's the way she washes her clothes. Wow, that was fantastic. And look at all these amazing bubbles. Can you give yourselves a bit of a clap? And should I put our monkey, should I put her just over here? I'll try not to get caught up in the wire though this time. Here we go. So if I pop you up here, there we go. And you can still see all the children at home, can't you? And they can all see you. Fantastic. So there's lots of sorts of fruits, aren't there? I've got lots of them in my greengrocer tray over here. And there are many, many more fruits as well. And we're going to think now about a very special sort of fruit that we can find out about in the Bible. It's called the fruit of the Spirit. And it's the fruit that God's Holy Spirit puts into us of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And we're going to sing all about those now. Here we go. So the first one is the fruit of the Spirit is not a coconut. Here we go. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now the fruit of the Spirit's not a strawberry. The fruit of the Spirit's not a strawberry. If you want to be a strawberry, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now the fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. The fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. If you want to be a banana, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Give yourselves a bit of a clap. We're going to revisit another favourite song now. This one is a song all about love, and it works to the tune of Row, Row, Row the Boat. So you need to see if you can find another person in your house who you can give them a bit of a cuddle to, if you're able to at the moment. Maybe a grown-up, or maybe a brother or a sister. And we'll sing this song to each other. Love, love, love your friends, love them all year long. Love is patient, love is kind, love is really strong. Love, love, love your friends, love them all year long. Love is patient, love is kind, love is really strong. Well done, that was fantastic. Well, we're going to do a bit of a game now. We're going to do a game all about love, all about joy, and all about peace. Now, I've got my music box just over here. You might remember this from last week. And when I put the music box up to the camera, you can see what happens when I turn the handle and open the lid. It does this. Did you hear that? It plays music. And that's a song by Elvis Presley called I Can't Help Falling In Love With You, one that I expect most of the grown-ups will know that one. So when you hear that music, that's a good time to try and find somebody who you can give a big cuddle to as a way of showing them that you love them. Then we're also going to have some joy. So for the joy, when we make the nice loud boppy music like that, then you can jump up and down and bang your drums. And then sometimes we might want to just say, let's have a quiet moment when we just say, shh. And when we go for that, we can all have a bit of a lie down and a bit of a rest. So the joy is going to be with the jumping up and down. The peace will be when it's nice and quiet. And the love will be when we open up our music box and make that work. So, shall we start off with some joy? Now let's have a bit of a rest and go for some peace. What's going to be next, do you think? fantastic. That was love. So that's a good one to give your grown-ups or your brothers or sisters a bit of a cuddle. What are we going to have next? Let's listen out for the sound. A bit of peace and quiet. And now some joy to be jumping up and down. And now to finish with, let's go nice and quiet again. Well done. Now then, I'm going to go and get our monkey back for this next activity. Okay. Now, this monkey, just before Mini Melodies, she had her breakfast, so she shouldn't really need any food yet. Until lunchtime, really. But this monkey keeps wanting to eat a banana. So it's not really time to eat a banana, because otherwise it will ruin her lunch for her and she won't be able to eat her lunch. So she needs some self-control, which is when she says no. But if you see her trying to eat the banana, maybe you could let me know by tapping your drums or banging your tapping sticks together like that, so that I know and you can help her to have some self-control. Let's give it a go. So watch out for the banana. Make sure it doesn't go too close to her mouth. Oh, I can hear a noise. Not yet. It's not time to eat your banana yet, okay? Wait till lunchtime. Well done, you. Okay, so thank you for helping me with that. And thank you for helping the monkey as well. If you see her trying to eat the bananas again, remember it's not quite time, so you need to tap your drums. Oh, I can hear some drumming again. Are you trying to eat the banana again? Not yet, okay? Let's take that away for a little bit. I'll put it over here, shall I? No, I don't think it's okay now. The banana's down here. Oh, it's gone. Hey, did you take the monkey? Did you? Oh, dear. Well, maybe waving a banana in front of you isn't very fair. So let's say thank you to everybody at home for helping our monkey to have some really good self-control there. And maybe if I pop you back over here, then it might be a bit easier for you so that you can still join in with all of the songs, but not be tempted by the big banana that you were enjoying eating there. There we go. If you sit there, you can see all the children at home and all the children at home can see you. Fantastic. Well, we've not got time for many more songs, but we have got time for one more dance. So if you've got a piece of floaty material, I've got my scarf back, but you might have a piece of cloth or you might have a towel, anything that you can dance with. And we've got a song all about one of the fruits of the spirit, which is all about love. And this is called Can You Feel the Love Tonight? And it's from the Lion King.
Disasters in the air.
Here we go. Okay, you wave your scarves around. You can stretch them up and put them down. Well done. What else could you do with your scarves, maybe? Just wave them side to side. Maybe for the next verse, you can go stretch up.
Many things to tell her.
Then bending down really low. The truth about and stretching up with one hand. She turned and going low and stretching up with another hand. Well done, that's brilliant. What else could we do with our scarves? Maybe we can wriggle them around. There we go. You've got enough space, you can wiggle it lots and lots. Well done. Maybe we could hide away this one, then pop out. Steady, steady, boom. Can you do that as well? Hide away. Go ready, steady, boom! Well done. Do some more dancing around. Imagine all the lions coming together for this song, like they do in The Lion King. Maybe you could do some lion actions as part of your dancing. Do a big rah! That. How do you think the lions might dance around to this song? What do you think? Now it's a bit quiet, just so shall we have a bit of a quiet part? Tonight. Oh, use your floaty material to keep you warm.
His carefree days with us are history. In short, our path.
And now for the big finish, give your scarves a big wave. Well done. Can you float them backwards and forwards and from side to side? Ah, fantastic. You did really, really well on that one, didn't you? Well, that is all we've got time for this week. Next week, we're going to be back with some of our favourite songs. So, if you've got any songs you really, really want to sing at Mini Melodies next week, if you can ask your grown-ups to send me a message in the links below, in the message button below, that's the word, or to send me an email, then it would be really, really nice to have all of those requests. I've already got a couple of songs, but I've got plenty of space for some more songs. So let me know what you'd like to sing, and we will try and include those in Mini Melodies next week. So we look forward to seeing you then. Bye-bye.